to all of you. I'm Alpna. Today I want to welcome you to the new chapter 5 from class 4, and the topic of the chapter is kinds of nouns. Okay, children, you have already studied about nouns. Okay, in the previous class you have already studied about nouns. Now we will be discussing about the types of the nouns here. Okay, so let's proceed with the definition. What is noun? A noun is a name of a person, a place, an animal or a thing. That you all know that it is a specific name of a person, a place, a thing or an animal. Okay. Now we will begin with the types. Number one is proper noun. Okay. Proper noun. This first one defines that a proper noun is the name of a particular person, place, animal or thing. It always begins with a capital letter. Wherever you are writing the proper noun, you will begin with a capital letter and you will end with a full stop. Here the proper noun starts with a capital letter and in the end of the sentence, you will end with a full stop. Now we will see the examples here. Harshita is our class monitor, which defines that Harshita is a proper noun and this name starts with a capital letter and the sentence ends with a full stop. Now second one, the Jama Masjid is a mosque in New Delhi. That means here the proper noun is Jama Masjid, which is written in the block letters. Fluffy, my pet, likes to play. Here the Fluffy is proper noun, which is written in the capital letter. My favorite book is Great Expectation. Here you have already seen that we have used the block letters or the capital letters to define the proper noun. The highlighted words are the names of a particular person, a place, an animal and a book. These are known as proper noun. Later on we will see the next noun. Okay, I'll write it and you will see. Okay, now I will be proceeding with the second type of the noun, that is common noun. What is the definition? A common noun is the name of a general place, person, animal or thing. It usually does not begin with a capital letter. That means it is a common name of a particular person, place, animal or the thing, which is known as common noun. And the example it will begin with, the boy went to the bakery to buy a cake. That means here this sentence does not define a specific boy or a bakery or a cake here. The highlighted word, see, the boy here is common, bakery is the common, cake is the common. It is not defining the specific name of the particular thing or the place or the person. Second one, my friend is reading a book. My friend, the name of the friend is not specific here and the book also is not specific. That means these both are the common noun. The driver stopped the car. That means the driver here is also not having a name or the car is also not having a brand. Therefore, these two are the common noun. The children went for a picnic. That means the children, the name of the children are not given here as well as the spot of the picnic is not defined. That means in these sentences, the highlighted words are the names of particular place, people or thing. These are common nouns. So, these highlighted words are common. Now, I will be giving you the collective noun. Now, I will be discussing the last part, okay? This is known as collective noun. So, the collective noun defines that a collective noun refers to the name of a collection of people, animals or thing. That means, it is a total collection of the animal or the thing. Here with the example I would like to make it very clear. For example, an army of soldiers attacked the enemies. That means to define the group of the soldiers we will write what? The word army. That is the special word army, which is the highlighted word and it is a collective noun. Second one, a herd of cattle. That means cattle. To define the group of cattle, herd is the special word used here, which is a collective noun. I received a bucket of flowers from my friend. That means a group of the flowers is being given or defined by the word bucket. These all highlighted words describe the collective nouns here. For the collective nouns, there are also
people. For example, a host of angels, a flock of tourists, a queue of soldiers. This means these are the collective nouns. Animals or birds, a brood of hens, a murder of crows, a troop of monkeys. For the king, a clump of trees, a sheep of peoples, and a set of troops. I hope that you have all understood these types of the nouns. You will go through the lesson and have a nice day.